Hi, in today's teardown, something very special. It is not a faucet. It is something I found for 30 euros on eBay, and I am very happy with it because it is extremely rare. We have here a medical device called a breathing pacemaker transmitter, a tube loop antennas, obviously. And here is the device. I will link in the doobly-doo below a few YouTube videos explaining how to use it, and also link to the user manual. According to the informations I found online, the whole cost of the device and the surgery of a patient is $60,000. So this box is called the Avery Mark IV, which is the breathing pacing transmitter. It is a device that will help people to breathe by themselves instead of using what they should normally need, an external ventilator machine. So it works with two antennas and actually two implanted electrodes in the patient. One for each lung, and which are powered and controlled by this loop antennas. According to the specifications, it works at around 2 MHz, but I did not find any information about the transmitting power exactly. So this box, it is a real beautiful piece, as you can see. We have two coil antennas wrapped in silicone with expensive LEMO plugs. So there are two pairs of similar controls, one for left side and one for right side of the patient, with an amplitude setting button containing an integrated dial. We have plug for the antenna. We have on-off switch for each side, antenna LED and battery status LED, and one single rate control. So I will connect the antennas. So it seems the patient can adjust exactly the rate and the amplitude according to its need, if he's doing a sport, if he's sleeping, or something like this. So if I power it on in a normal condition, as you can see, the A and B lights will blink together according to the rate you did set. If you have a battery problem, it looks like the B battery B light will not turn on, but it is not something you want in a medical device. That you have a battery failing without previous warning. So it is a little bit odd. We have very dim red LEDs, as you can see. They are shining, but very, very dim. So there is quite a few information online about this device, luckily. And there is something very particular I will show you. So I can turn it off, I can unplug the antennas. Of course, I am missing here the implanted part of the device. It is the only thing I do not have. It was not retrieved from the patient, apparently. Or this is an extra unit that was not associated to a particular pair of receivers inside somebody. So, what is very special about this? It is not every day you carry a pacemaker device in your hands, whether it is an external or internal pacemaker. It is not every day you take apart a pacemaker, obviously. And it is not never, almost, you take apart a pacemaker without any tools. But today is the day. because this thing can actually be taken apart without any tool. Here we have at the bottom the battery box, which will open like so. We have here a very thick machined aluminium piece as a battery cover with a little bit of foam. And we have two 9-volt batteries. It is one for each side of the patient. And one interesting detail here about these batteries is that the wire is stuck inside, but it is not the matter here. Look at this. They did not use off-the-shelf battery contacts like this one, what you could expect. It is something custom with apparently a piece of maybe thick cardboard or even circuit board in the middle, insulative layer, and all attached with silicone sealant. So maybe this is more reliable than using a regular battery contact. It is quite interesting. So we have two times the same thing. On the back here we have, I will first remove this because it will be easier, we have a bunch of information settings. So they are not the user adjustable settings, they are the practitioner settings probably. You will adjust one time and not modify until the next checkup. You have the information about the company who made it. And you have a serial number of 54,482. So, I will remove the other panel. These panels on the side are FR4 material, it seems. Regular circuit board material. And we have one circuit board with, it looks like we have no integrated circuit. No, we have transistors, capacitors, diode, and resistors, and it is all. So no microprocessor, no memory, no operational amplifier, nothing, only good old school through all transistors and passive components. It is quite interesting. A few trimmers, of course, here at the bottom. So one thing I did notice, the circuit board is not conformal coated, which is quite weird because it is a device you are supposed to carry all the time with you. So it may get some moisture from temperature variation or rainy day or anything. So it is not watertight and no conformal coating on the circuit board. Quite surprising. On the side here you can see how the case is made with two parts of extruded aluminium, very long screw attaching them to the front piece, which is a very serious piece of machined aluminium. Here you have buttons on the potentiometers, on the LEMO plugs going to the top. On the bottom here it is written serial number here. But actually, it is on the other side, which to only have this, some gold plating and some tracks. No component on this side, and apparently two little screws to secure the circuit board to the top piece. So it was a really easy teardown, at least. No need of a Dremel, no need of a screwdriver or anything. I am very happy of this device because it is, I believe, something really unusual, and for sure it will become a flagship in my pacemakers collection. So I can put it back together in just a matter of seconds. So I hope you did enjoy this weird device. Very, very nice quality, really. So if you are giving it to a kid or child, You do not want him to modify the settings, and you do not want him to open the device. So it is a little bit weird how it is made. In the YouTube video or a photo somewhere, I saw someone who did secure this with a sticky tape to prevent them from turning. Maybe I saw if you carry in a pouch or anything like this, it may modify by itself. So it is not completely secure, but if you wrap some sticky tape around here, it will prevent them from turning. This one is a little less easy to reach. So check the videos in the box below. There is some interesting stuff, and so the user manual. So really beautiful device. Unexpected find on eBay, as always. You were browsing eBay and you find unexpectedly something very interesting, and you are the only bidder and you get it for a little price. So this is really a keeper for my pacemaker collection. Make sure to check also my other pacemaker videos in the video description, and also a few other pacemaker teardowns that are available on YouTube. It is Mike Electric Stuff, I believe. And Dave Jones from EEV Blog must do sometime soon implantable defibrillator teardown, but for now it is not released yet. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye bye.